I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And I'm Quentin.
And it is Tired Thursday. Because why? Because we're both tired. Okay, now let's get started with your morning announcements. Attention, juniors and seniors. The Global Trade and Logistics After School class is now accepting applications. Students will be required to attend class on Tuesdays from 4:15 to 5:15 p.m. Classes start on February 22nd, and students in this class will be eligible for a paid internship. They will also offer career and employment readiness. Do not miss out on this great opportunity. Applications are available in the Career Center.
Attention Tridents, CSF or California Scholarship Federation is taking applications for members of Semester 2. Benefits of joining CSF are learning about college requirements. You can earn scholarships as a senior, visit universities, and have community service opportunities. All grades levels are encouraged to apply. If you're interested in learning more about what CSF and how to apply, attend the short informational meeting during lunch today in F216.
Karen Transition Leaders, there will be a mandatory meeting in Ms. Nagy's room, E213, during lunch tomorrow for 8th grade orientation training. See you there.
Dance Club meets today in the gym. Come join us to learn new routines performed yesterday at lunch. Everyone is welcome.
Tridents, there will be a Key Club meeting today during lunch in E220. Everyone is welcome to join. See you there, Tridents.
Seniors!
Oh, yay! Yeah!
Senior quotes are now on sale for $10. Go to room F215 to pay and fill out with the quote form. Deadline is February 9th, no exceptions. If you have purchased a senior year package, you still need to go to F215 to fill out the quote form and get your quote approved. Don't procrastinate. Get yours as soon as possible. Any questions, go see Mrs. Castagnon in F215.
Now passing on to weather.
All right, it's one-arm weather. It's one-arm weather Thursday. It'd be better if it was Wednesday, a little more alliteration. Anyway, let's see if I can I move to the left, move to the right. Can I point? Let's go this way. No, this way, right here. 64, right? 64. Last of the cool days. And then you can see as I walk out of the shot here. Nice warm up tomorrow, back to 69. Those Santa Ana winds make a return. Not too strong, but we're back into the 70s over the weekend and all the way into next week. So that's good. Good news. Nice temperatures. Bad news. January, which is typically our wettest month, nothing, right? And now we're into February. So we talk about that good start we had. We're over 10 inches, but we need 14 to have it be a normal year. So we still need some more rain. We'll see what happens. We'll keep you updated, passing it over to sports.
Okay.
What's up, Tritons? I'm Jeanette.
And I'm April, and let's get started with your sports announcements.
Tritons, are there any boys interested in playing golf for this upcoming spring season? Please attend the informational meeting in MO9 today at the start of lunch. Any questions, please see or email Coach Tackett.
Tritons, girls basketball has their senior night tonight against Romesa, JV at 5:30 and varsity at 7. Come out and show your support for the girls, and congratulations to all the seniors celebrating tonight.
Congrats. Tritons, any boys interested in playing volleyball in the spring, but you're in the winter sport currently, do not worry, you will be able to try out next week in the gym.
Tritons, boys soccer has their senior night tonight. Make sure to come out and show your support, and congratulations to all the senior boys.
Congratulations. And that's it for us. Now passing it over.
Good morning, Tritons. Happy Thursday. Mrs. Nelson here with the Wellness Center, and I'm back with the Co-Vitality Survey. So you all have one more day to complete the survey, and we're still giving out prizes, these cool JBL speakers. So yesterday we pulled out two names, and can I get a drum roll, please, for our new winners? So today's winners are Marilyn Bomar and Oncelo Cruz. So you both have won a JBL speaker. Please come to the Wellness Center in room M26, nutrition, lunch, or after school and pick these up. And then also it was Manuela and Diana from yesterday. We have your speakers in the Wellness Center. So for all of you who have not completed the Co-Vitality Survey, please go ahead and do so. You still have a chance to win some speakers. And then students, we're having our lunch and learn next Wednesday. An email will be sent out to all of you to sign up. There's only a limited spot of like 40 kids. So once you see that email, sign up. It's going to be about healthy relationships. And that's it for me, passing it over to the Career Center.
Good morning, Tritons. I hope you're all having a great morning. Just a couple of reminders. Seniors, make sure that you are reviewing My Google Classroom. I've been posting scholarships almost on a daily basis, and I want to make sure that you are applying for these scholarships. If you are a junior or senior who picked up the application for the pre-engineering after-school class, I just want to remind you that the deadline for you to turn it in is tomorrow, so make sure that if you still have it, you turn it in. Also, seniors, don't forget if you're planning to apply for the Seal of Biliteracy, make sure that you apply by the 18th. I wanted to show you this is the cord that you would wear during graduation. In addition, you would also get a medal. Every year I get seniors wanting the cord, you know, in June. By then it is too late because we do have to order them. So make sure that you apply by the deadline, which is February 18th. That's all I have for you. Passing it over.
Hi, guys. I'm Sarai, president of Anime Club.
And I'm Marcos, the vice president.
And today we just wanted to tell you we're going to have our meeting today in H117 instead of our regular room, H117. Mm-hmm. And we're also just going to be talking about information, that just some important information, so please come out today. And
yeah, it's because Mr. Sid no longer works here. He left us for a better position, not even for money. I mean, if you're going to quit a job, you might as well do it for more money.
And that's it for us. Passing it over to Video Game Club.
Yeah, okay. Good morning, Tritons. It's your favorite Video Game Club president, Micah, here. And I'm here on behalf of the club to share some announcements with you guys. But first, you know, I've heard that kissing is the language of love. Would you care to have a conversation with me about it sometime? You know, you saying? Yeah? No? No?
Okay.
That's all good. That's fine. All right, so let's get on with something serious. So tomorrow will be our last day to sign up for the Smash Tournament. I will be coming back on tomorrow as well to show this, but yeah. So again, our tournament is for those who want to apply for our esports Smash team. You guys do have to be committed to be a part of this team, so it's going to be like an everyday thing that we're going to be practicing. So yeah, you'll be competing in a 1v1 in a series of, like, depending on how many players, but it's going to be a series of three rounds during that, and that's going to be all of next week. That will be our tournament week. So again, the QR code did show up. If you can pull that up again, if that's okay. It'll pull up some eventually, but yeah, the Google form is also in our Discord. So if you are part of our Discord, the Google form is also there under announcements. So you guys can check that out. I will be coming back on tomorrow again to show the QR code, because tomorrow is our final day. And my last announcement for Video Game Club is that on Tuesday, on February 8th, we will be having a Video Game Club pizza night. So please come by. We're going to be having pizza during our club meeting so we could talk about the Smash Tournament. Alrighty, so that'll be it for me. Passing it over.
All right, you're up, guys.
I'm Mimi.
I'm Josh.
And we are from BSU talking about another important African-American figure named Crispus Attucks.
Crispus Attucks was known as an escaped slave and the first American colonist to be killed in the Boston Massacre in the American Revolution.
He is known as a hero and patriot in the African-American community. Please check out this video of him.
His name will go down in history. But who is this man? Boston, 1770. A mob, angered by rising taxation imposed from London, confronts British troops. As tensions rise, the first shots of the American Revolution are fired. The first to die is Crispus Attucks. His name will go down in history. But who was this man, and why did he put himself in the line of fire? Born into slavery to an African father and a Native American mother, Attucks first enters the history books in 1750, when the Boston Gazette reported that he had run away from slave owner William Brown. Having managed to evade capture, Attucks struck out for a new life as a free black man. He had become a sailor and was serving as part of a crew in Boston by 1770, when tensions were running high in the city. British soldiers had been sent there to enforce the much-hated Townshend Acts, which had increased taxes on American merchants. Tensions rose further when, in February 1770, an 11-year-old boy was shot dead by the Brits who were breaking up an unruly crowd. On the evening of March 5th, the town was on edge. Many expressed their dissatisfaction, including Attucks, and he paid for it with his life. News of the Boston Massacre soon spread. According to the Boston Gazette, vengeful British troops mowed down an innocent crowd. But during a subsequent trial, it was revealed that Attucks and others may have attacked the British soldiers first with stones and balls of ice. As a result, Attucks was lionized by American patriots, who used his image as a symbol of resistance against British rule. And during the 19th century, abolitionists used Attucks as an icon to protest against slavery. Crispus Attucks has become a powerful emblem of the American Revolution. When it comes to such icons, do you think facts or symbols matter more? Want to know more about our nation's history? Why not subscribe to our...
All right, happy Thoughts on Thursday from the PBIS team. Okay, that was some great information regarding Black History Month. If you have any questions about Black... the information regarding Black History Month or the Black Student Union or what we're doing here on campus, you can go see Coach Dillon. He has all the BSU information you need. He's out in the PE department, or you can see him during PE or between classes. So go reach out to him. Today I'm going to bring back the one-liners. I was talking to some teachers. Want to make sure that we are still abiding by these. I know it's kind of tough with the portables and moving about campus, but let's roll those one-liners. Take me another shot. This is still really important. We're still getting people jammed up in the hallways, even walking through the gates. Make sure we're following those, staying to the right as we're walking and talking. Okay, we have those arrows pointed on going to the gates through out from the blacktop or the new portables into the main quad. So stay to the right so we can get through so we all don't get jammed up. I've also seen a lot of people being very courteous going in and out of the H and J buildings, waiting for everyone to exit and then having people enter. Make sure your headphones, if you're out and about, you can at least hear the information if somebody's trying to talk to you. Just have maybe one in as you're walking around campus. It's real difficult when we're trying to get a hold of somebody and they can't hear what we're saying. So just have one in. As you're coming to class, take off your headphones, take off your hats. If your teachers want your hats off, get ready to work, get your computers out. Make sure that you are prepared for class as you enter. Okay, next slide, please. Remember, keep it classy. I've been out subbing a little bit. Sometimes we use inappropriate language in class, not knowing that we're doing it. So let's just try to keep everything classy here at Pacifica. Next slide, please. This is for those of us, if we're coming into spring, we're looking for a boyfriend, girlfriend, we're looking for someone to be around. Yes, just give them a hug and tell them, hey, I'll see you later. You don't need to get into a full-blown makeout session in the middle in front of everybody else. Okay, too much information. Okay. This is honor the dress code. This is going to be addressed, but this will be talked about more going forward in regards to professional team jerseys, that types, those types of clothes being worn on campus. But let's just say when you come to school, take a look at yourself in the mirror and make sure that you are looking good and ready to take on the day's work. All right, next slide. This one is I wanted to put in 10 minutes. We're not letting people go to the bathroom 10 minutes at the start of class, nor 10 minutes at the end of class. As I've been around subbing some classrooms, a lot of students are thinking, because I'm a sub, I don't know what's going on. They ask, oh, I need to go to the bathroom right now. No, this is to make sure we can clear the campus. The campus security can get everybody to their classrooms, and we know who is out wandering and loitering on campus. Okay, so that is from the PBIS team. For me personally now, those of us who are boys who are interested in playing golf this year, please come to my room, MO9, at the start of lunch for a quick 5-minute informational meeting. We'll be talking about clearance, tryouts, the upcoming season. So anyone, you do not have to have any experience. You don't have to have any golf clubs. But anybody interested in golf, please come to MO9 right at the beginning of lunch today. Okay, signing off from the PBIS team, like they always say, from Coach Pike, if you stay ready, you never have to get ready. Have a great Thursday, everyone, and I'm sending over to Club News.
Hey, I know you guys already got your Key Club news and everything, but update, we are pushing our meeting to next week. Something unfortunate happened, and we really have this game planned out, and we want to ensure that it's a fun experience, especially since we've been on month-long hiatus. So to ensure that, we are going to be pushing it next week and give you guys the best experience. So make sure to check our Instagram for updates and our Google Classroom. Passing it over.
That's the end of our show. Key Club is next week, I think, if I heard right.
And then seniors, get your senior quilts in. Don't procrastinate, y'all.
Yep. And then also, ski week is around the corner, so we got a week off.
Yeah. Woo!
Thank you.
And then also CSF, check if you're CSF qualified if you're interested in being in the club. And thank you very much. That's the end of our show.
Okay. Bye.
Bye. Have a good day.